Hello friends, hope you're all well, and welcome once again. Well, 2022 is almost up, which has been a pretty straightforward year in terms of content uploaded to this channel, mostly consisting of my solo redubs, but that has meant a lot of you have heard the various voices I give all the characters on Thomas. So I think that felt like a perfect time to sit down with you all and explain a little bit about all the different voices I give the characters. You know, the inspiration, what they are based on, who they are based on, and, you know, you might get a few interesting answers in here. So, I've got my Christmas stocking here, which I have filled with all my TWR characters. So, I'm going to stick my hand in like a lucky dip, and whichever character I pull out, I will explain a little bit about the voice for them. So, I'll only do a few today as a part one, and then if this video does quite well, good reception, I will do a part number two. So, just let me know in the comments if you'd like to do that, and just learn a little bit more about all the voice acts, all the characters I voice, and the inspiration behind them all. So, let's start with this, part one of explaining all the voices I do for Thomas. So, with that said and done, let's stick my hand aside, have a feel, and who is the first character? We're off to a great start here, Rosie. I can't do female voices. I can't lie. Yeah, if there really is no one better to voice Rosie in your little redub or project, I don't know if I can do my best. And I've never done it. I probably should have prepared myself for this. But I guess it's a bit of a sweet, you know, slight feminine voice, because Rosie is just the gentlest character in Thomas, without a doubt. And, you know, he's like got such a lovely smile. As long as you're smiling, you can do a very good Rosie voice. A very soft voice, and yeah, there are much better choices for Rosie, for any female character in the show, so hopefully this video isn't going to consist of me pulling out female characters, because this won't be very impressive. Come on, someone good please for this next one. Good one. Much better. Spencer, dear me, I'll put some good stuff on him. Anyway, I'll give him a clean. Anyway, Spencer, one of the advice I would give, my Spencer, Gordon, and the Fat Controller voice are a bit too similar for my liking. I still need to work on them a little bit. But Spencer is very Sideshow Bob from The Simpsons. Kelsey Grammer, as you all know, in my celebrity voices video, I thought Kelsey Grammer would be the perfect voice for Spencer. And, you know, obviously inspired by Alice Robb, as we know, the voice he used for Sideshow Bob with The Simpsons. And that just felt so perfect, you know, this sophisticated, slow, very deep, posh voice, you know. Oh, what? I just despise you. It's more, oh, Gordon, that record should have been mine. And, you know, basically that, yes. You know, very, very deep, you know, slightly menacing Spencer voice, which works for Hero of the Rails. So, you know, if anyone's ever doing a read-up for Hero of the Rails, I would very, very much enjoy voicing Spencer in that, because, you know, he's definitely a brilliant antagonist in that film. Paxton, okay. Don't get to voice in CGI read-ups very often, because they're not done very often, because it's very hard for us voice actors, because we have to make sure we are in sync with the animation. So that's a bit of a nightmare, and it's no wonder we don't do them very often. But Paxton is, you know, what's his name? I already forget. Kerry Schell, is it? Who voices Paxton now? Either way, his voice for him is great, and it's a bit slow, you know, but it's hard to stick, it's really easy to stick to, and, Paxton, you know, as you just keep saying arm all the time, yeah, slightly confused, slightly a bit very slow, a bit behind, but, you know, he's also got a heart of gold in the show, and we love Paxton. No one's got a bad word to say about Paxton, so I very much enjoy voicing him. I haven't had to do so very often, but I do. How about main character? What about on the Steam team? Aha! There we go, right on cue, Gordon. Gordon, probably same again as Spencer. Very posh and deep and high and proud and fast. You know, Keith Wickham again, the magic of Keith Wickham, it works very well for Gordon, and it's probably always going to be inspired by that. So that's my personal preference for him. Express coming through! And there you go. And it's you just go from there. Posh, deep, proud, bit snooty, you know. You know, it's Gordon. Keith Wickham just nails the voice of Gordon, and I would happily say he's my main inspiration for the voice. And in Clarabelle, that's the thing with female voices. I could do those very posh, high-pitched female voices. But you would convert that. That's, you know, obviously like a dame would, like a dame in a pantomime would use that voice. You know, hello, and you know, Annie and Clarabelle or Dowager Hatch, you know, characters like that. Really posh, upper class female voices. You know, that are shocked and disgusted and appalled by everything they hear. You know, ooh, I say, you know, voices like us. I that's probably the most effective female voice I can do. So yeah, if you need Annie and Clarabelle or a Dowager Hat voice, drop me a line, I guess. Okay, Odol and Douglas. I won't recommend asking me to voice both of them, because they probably wouldn't sound the same. But I do like what was it Michael Angelis tried doing slightly higher, different pitches for the voices of Odol and Douglas. Donald, a bit lower Scottish accent, you know, and voice a lot. And Douglas is a bit more, it's slightly higher, you know, and slightly more enthusiastic. And I obviously, you might have seen a series I did with Peter Sam and Eric Age Engine where I voiced Douglas. Slightly hard at times to nail the voice. I think it probably kept chopping and changing. If I look back on them, it probably would sound a bit inconsistent. But I'm getting there with a Scottish accent. It's good to do. But you also got to sound really enthusiastic for Odol and Douglas, because they are Caledonian, as Wilbert himself was it. So Odol and Douglas, yep, Scottish accent. You know, you can change the pictures depending on your mood, and it's as simple as that, really. So, do not fast yourself. Bill. So, Bill and Ben. Yep, another from one set of twins to another. Bill and Ben. It's very similar to my Percy voice, you know, these slightly young Cockney accents, you know, easily intimidated voices, a bit annoyed, you know, you can't talk to me like that, bossy boiler. And, yeah, I think they work with, I think they have to be Cockney to be, like, show this, show, to say to the bigger edges, don't mess with me, don't tip me off, you know, because like I just think back to those particularly young characters in EastEnders, the kids, you know, all a bit mouthy, and you know, easily annoyed. I think back to those, and I think that works, you know, when they're shouting back to their parents. I think they're like young and Cockney, high pitched. I think I'm in the, you know, nice and. Can talk and out-talk their parents, you know, or their superior, you know. I like that. So Bill and Ben and Percy to an extent, you know, like nice Cockney high pitched accents, and easily annoyed. You can't talk to me like that. And I think it works for them. Cheeky as well. Final one. Diesel. Looking forward to talking about this one. Diesel. I tend to chop and change with Diesel, not gonna lie. You know, his current voice, Kerry Shale in the current series, and you know, I'm full of surprises, you know, that works. But also when I did in my Tender Edges redub that came out of nowhere, but I really like it, and I'm glad I did, was inspired by John Challis as Boise in Only Fools and Horses. And it just worked for me, because Cockney for Diesel works, you know, just you know, slightly intimidating, but then when you give it like the Boise kind of voice for Diesel, he sounds way more sophisticated, which it suits his choice of words, his vocabulary when he arrives on Sodor and he says, "We are revolutionary," and so I've got to try and get into it. "I'm afraid that no amount of tenders will go to save you in the end. We Diesels are taking over, and we don't need tenders to make us feel good. Not even one." I'm still working on the laugh, but yeah, Diesel pretty much inspired by Boise from Only Fools and Horses. You know, Maureen! So, Lord rest John Challis. He just came to me in the middle of when I was doing the redub for Tender Edges, and I think it works. But I would go back to his CGI voice.
Do I sound like a snake? Does that sound like a diesel horn? Peep, peep. You know, something like that. And then, you know, just go, but, yeah. If you want a sophisticated version of Diesel, I would do the Boise voice. So there we go. That's a few characters and their voices, but done by me. Again, love to know if there's a part two. If you like this idea, I will definitely do more because I'm very passionate for this idea. There are loads more characters to do, some of which I have a decent amount to say about. So thanks for watching, as always. Like the video if you enjoyed. Subscribe to the channel if you have not already done so. And I hope to see you very soon. And if it's not before Christmas, Merry Christmas to you, and have a very happy New Year. Take care, everyone. Cheerio.